the secret behind Al-Imam Al-Jazuli's writing the book, it was a miracle. But indeed, the book became a book of miracles because it changes people's life. And over centuries, the Muslim Ummah embraced this book. Hanafi scholars, Maliki scholars, Shafi'i scholars, Hanbali scholars from all directions. Take, for example, the great Hanbalite Mufti of Syria, Sheikh Abdul Baqi ibn Abdul Baqi al-Ba'li al-Hanbali, one of the greatest Hanbali scholars, and follows also the Aqidah of the Athar. That is to say, not Ash'ari, not Maturidi, follows the Aqidah of the Muhaddith and the Aqidah of Tafweed. That is the Aqidah of Tafweed. That is to say, when we come across ambiguous verses in Al-Quran al-Kareem, we don't confirm the literal meaning and we don't opt for interpretation. We say, Allahu a'lamu bi muradih, Allah knows what is meant by that. We believe in everything that has come down to us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we don't delve into it. But at the same time, we don't confirm the literal meaning. And this is a very important key point in the Aqidah of the Salaf radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. This book is a compilation of prayers. When that young woman said to him, go and compile, he wanted to compile the best forms that were written before him, alongside also some of his own. So he compiled salawat written by the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum. So there is a salah of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. There is a salah by Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Abbas. There's a lengthy text salah, Allahumma dahi al-madhuwat wa bari al-masmukat, attributed to Sayyiduna Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Imam Shafi'i opened al-Risala with a beautiful text. Al-Risala of Imam Shafi'i is known to be a very eloquent text of the Arabic language, not just an educational text, I would say. No, it is actually a very eloquent piece of art in Arabic literature. The best of it is the introduction, where he mentions some forms of prayers, including this form, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin adada ma dhakarahu al-dhakirun wa ghafala an dhikrihi al-ghafilun. O Allah, send your blessings upon our master Muhammad as much as people remember him and as much as people forget to mention him, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Imam Al-Jazuli borrowed this and went further to borrow a special salawat from Sheikh Abdul Qadir Al-Jilani, whose teachings had reached Morocco before Al-Imam Al-Jazuli, to Al-Qutb Abu Madian, Al-Ghawth, and several other great men of Allah. And took also from Sheikh Al-Akbar Muhyiddin ibn Al-Arabi, Al-Hatimi, Al-Ta'i, several forms of prayers. He took the hadith of the Fada'il from Ihya Ulum al-Din, few other books. So there is no blame on Al-Imam Al-Jazuli for quoting a hadith that has no reference, for example. He did not invent anything himself. He relied on well-known works in his time and took his information from these books. He wrote his own forms also. He expressed his love, his attachment to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. You can see from the book that he put a lot of his soul. There's a piece of him in the book. His heart is in the book.
اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على من اسمه أشرف الأسماء سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم سيدنا أحمد صلى الله وسلم عليه وعلى آله.